లోక్సభ సమావేశాలు జరుగుతూనే ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారం చూద్దాం.
Now government within what 24 hours, whatever action was to be taken, it is taken, and government is ready to discuss on the issue of Delhi unfortunate incident on 11th in this house. I want that this question hour should kindly, you may continue, sir.
Yes, sir. Ajay Ranjan Chowdhury, if you tell your members to go back to their seats, that cannot happen. That never happens. That your members will be on the well and you will be allowed to speak. That never happens. There are certain political parties who also make their point of view standing in the chair when they are allowed to speak. It is not by disruption, not running to the well, not jumping to the well, not jumping to the well, not jumping to the well, you can make your point of view. It is not done in this house. It is not done in parliamentary practices. Now I call question number 202. Sri Vasant Kumar. Sir, reply to this. Answer to be made on the table of the house. Second question.
29 positive cases have been reported so far. Of these, 3 cases were reported in Kerala earlier, who have since recovered and have been discharged already. Since last 3 days, new travel-related cases have tested positive. These include one in Delhi having travel history of Italy and Telangana having travel history from Dubai and contact history from person from Singapore. Both are clinically stable. 6 more cases have tested positive in Agra, Uttar Pradesh, having contact history with the case in Delhi. Required action as per cluster management plan has been initiated. Further, an Italian tourist and his wife have tested positive in Rajasthan. 14 other accompanying tourists in this group and their Indian bus driver tested positive on their return to Delhi. All of them are reported to be stable. A recent positive case has also been reported in Delhi yesterday, having travel history from Italy and is stable. The ever increasing magnitude of this outbreak globally calls for a concerted effort by not only health but all sectors of the government. Honorable Prime Minister is personally monitoring the preparedness and response on a regular basis. Government of India has initiated a series of action to prevent entry of the disease and to contain it. I am daily reviewing the situation. A group of ministers consisting of Minister of External Affairs, Minister of Civil Aviation and Minister of State for Home Affairs, Minister of State for Shipping and Minister of State for Health and Family Welfare, chaired by me, have been constituted to monitor the situation. The group of ministers has met 4 times since its inception on 3rd February 2020. Cabinet Secretary is taking regular reviews with all related ministries of Health, Defence, Ministry of External Affairs, Civil Aviation, Home, Textiles, Pharma, Commerce and other officials, including with State Chief Secretaries. My own ministry is constantly reviewing the evolving scenario. Video conferences are being held with states every other day. Government of India has also taken several measures to control the risk of novel coronavirus infection spreading to India. Our first travel advisory was issued on 17th of January 2020, and as situation is evolving, the travel advisories are accordingly getting revised. Presently, it prescribes, number 1, all regular sticker visas, e-visas including visa on arrival for Japan and South Korea, granted to nationals of Italy, Iran, South Korea, Japan and issued on or before 3rd of March 2020 and who have not yet entered India, stand suspended with immediate effect. Regular sticker visa, e-visa granted to nationals of People's Republic of China, issued on or before 5th of Feb 2020 were suspended earlier. It shall remain in force. Regular sticker visas, e-visas granted to all foreign nationals who have travelled to People's Republic of China, Iran, Italy, South Korea and Japan on or after 1st of Feb 2020 and who have not yet entered India stand suspended with immediate effect. Diplomats, officials of the United Nations and other international bodies, OCI card holders and air crew from above countries are exempted from such restriction on entry. However, their screening at the point of entry is compulsory. Passengers of all international flights entering into India from any port are required to furnish duly filled self-declaration form, including personal particulars like phone number and address in India and travel history to health officials and immigration officials at all airports. Indian citizens are advised to refrain from travel to China, Iran, Republic of Korea, Italy and Japan and advised to avoid all non-essential travel to other COVID-19 affected countries. Screening of passengers was initiated in the country since 18th of January 2020. Initially, airports at Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Kolkata, Bengaluru, Hyderabad and Kochi were covered and subsequently expanded in a total of 21 airports. As per the evolving situation, initially, universal screening was taken up for all passengers coming via direct flights from China, South Korea, Japan, Iran, Italy, Hong Kong, Vietnam, Malaysia, Indonesia, Nepal, Thailand and Singapore. Since yesterday, directions have also been issued for universal screening for all international passengers coming in the country. Signages have been displayed at prominent places in airports and ports. In-flight announcements are being made and self-declaration forms are being filled up by all the passengers. As on 4th March, a total of 6,241 flights have been screened, covering a total of 6,11,167 passengers. Teams of specialist doctors were sent to all the airports to ensure effective screening and arrangement for isolation in the attached hospitals. Screening of passengers has also been initiated in 12 major seaports and 65 minor seaports, minor ports in the country to identify passengers and crew coming from China and to isolate them in case they are found symptomatic. As on 4th March, 16,076 persons have been screened at the ports. Government has initiated screening in all integrated checkposts with bordering countries in collaboration with states of UP, Uttarakhand, West Bengal, Sikkim and Bihar and Seema Shastra Bal and land port authorities. Gram Sabhas have been conducted in villages adjoining the borders to create awareness amongst people about the disease and precautions to be taken in collaboration with Panchayati Raj Ministry. 8 central teams visited the bordering villages in states of UP, Uttarakhand, West Bengal, Sikkim and Bihar to review the activities at the border crossing, the conduct of Gram Sabhas and risk communication to the community. A total of 3,823 Gram Sabhas have been organized in villages adjoining the border and 11,20,529 persons have been screened at the borders. In view of the continuing lockdown of the Hubei province in China, the Government of India decided to evacuate the Indian students and other professionals working in Wuhan and neighboring cities in the Hubei province. In a coordinated operation with Ministry of Civil Aviation, Air India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, 2 special Air India flights were operated between Delhi and Wuhan on 31st January and 1st Feb 2020 that brought back a total of 654 passengers that included 647 Indian citizens, including 2 Indian embassy officials who were on the ground in Wuhan to coordinate the evacuation operation, and 7 Maldivian nationals. These evacuees were kept in Army Quarantine Center at Manesar and ITBP camp at Chawla. All these evacuees were tested after 14 days. and on being found negative, discharged on 18th of Feb 2020. Further, Indian Air Force on 26th Feb 2020 has evacuated a total of 112 people from Wuhan, which included 76 Indians and nationals from Myanmar, Bangladesh, Maldives, China, South Africa, USA, and Madagascar. The evacuees reached Delhi on 27th Feb morning and are kept at ITBP camp for quarantine for a period of 14 days as per the protocol. I am happy to inform that they have all tested negative so far and are stable. This flight also had carried personal protective equipments, disposables and medical equipments, which was given as a goodwill gesture to China from the Indian government. The Indian embassy and consulates are also in regular contact with the Indian community in other parts of China and is keeping a constant track of their well-being. Another evacuation was successfully carried out by Air India by bringing back 124 people on 27th Feb morning, including 5 foreign nationals who were aboard the COVID-19 infected cruise ship Diamond Princess from port of Yokohama, Japan. They are kept in army facility at Manesar for 14 days quarantine presently. I am happy to highlight that even these evacuees have tested negative and are stable. Regular surveillance has been initiated across the country for all cases having travel history from all major COVID-19 affected countries and for people having contact with such persons and having fever, cough or breathlessness. Through integrated disease surveillance network, all such persons are tracked, and as on 4th March, a total of 28,529 persons were brought under community surveillance and are being monitored. The state surveillance officers, district surveillance officers, and rapid response teams of health professionals under the leadership of the state health secretaries are monitoring all such people on a daily basis. Sufficient isolation beds have been made available in the tertiary facilities across the country to manage any outbreak. Ministry has issued guidelines to support states on surveillance and contact tracing. Surveillance at points of entry, laboratory samples collection, packaging and transport, clinical management protocol, and infection prevention and control in healthcare facilities to ensure availability of critical items like personal protective equipments and N95 masks. The exports of the same were also restricted. A buffer stock of personal protective equipments and N95 masks is maintained by states as well as the union government. National Institute of Virology, Pune is the nodal laboratory. As part of ICMR's preparedness for re-emerging infectious disease, NIV Pune has established capacity for molecular diagnosis of COVID-19. Next generation sequencing is also established. Testing of clinical samples has also been initiated in 15 more laboratories. Another 9 laboratories are being prepared to test samples to ensure adequate geographical spread across the country. The network is being further expanded. Risk communication material has been prepared and is widely disseminated even in regional languages through states. Required awareness in communities ensured through technical briefings by experts in radio and television. Daily press briefing is being held by the Ministry of Health and information is being shared through social media also. A 24/7 control room is operational with call center number as 011-2397-8046. So far, more than 9,200 calls have been attended, including 667 international calls. Government of India is in regular touch with the World Health Organization's headquarters, regional office, and the country office to get updates on the evolving scenario. Our focus is on adherence to core capacities for disease preparedness and response, which include surveillance, laboratory diagnosis, hospital preparedness, logistics management, capacity building of healthcare staff, and risk communication to the community. The scale and extent of our interventions have increased in alignment with the evolving situation of COVID-19 across the world and India in particular. With the increasing global spread of the diseases, we are confronted with new challenges. The contact tracing of positive cases requires tracing of hundreds of contacts in multiple locations and monitoring their health. Similarly, the cases in Agra being transmitted to family members by the confirmed case has necessitated putting up a containment plan to contain the cluster of cases in Agra. Another major area of concern is Indian pilgrims and students stranded in Tehran and Qom, Iran epicenters of the Iran COVID-19 outbreak. Government of India is following up with Iran authorities for their well-being and to tie up evacuation as per need. In addition to manage travel-related cases, additional challenge is to contain clusters due to local transmission that requires highly resource-intensive containment operations. We have provided the containment action plan to all the states. A national-level training workshop has been planned for all the states and hospitals from other ministries on COVID-19 management on 6th of March 2020, which will then be taken up to district level. Senior officers of the ministry have been deputed to states and UTs to review their preparedness and provide required guidelines in the containment efforts. We have designated district collector as the nodal officer at field level for containment operations. States have been guided in terms of identifying containment zone, buffer zone, and preparation of micro plan to ensure effective, active, and passive surveillance and contact tracing through interdisciplinary teams in the areas where cases are located. I want to inform this House that the government is taking all necessary measures to prevent the spread of COVID-19 in India. I seek your cooperation in this particular endeavor. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister. Thank you. Please try to understand this is a statement. And if at all you are willing, I can allow you to make your suggestions. Because the suggestion for action only. Rather than discussion and again. LOP. Quick.
Sir, मैं स्वास्थ्य मंत्री ने बहुत विस्तार से स्टेटमेंट दिया उस पे मुझे कुछ नहीं कहना आपने अवगत कराया पूरे देश को क्या दुनिया में हो रहा जैसे ऑनरेबल चेयरमैन ने कहा